Hare Krishna. To understand one thing, we sometimes need to revise how we understand everything. Often, we seek to understand, say, one particular concept, but that concept may be so complicated or rather so intricately connected with various other concepts that we have previously understood, that to understand it, we need to change how we have understood everything. So, for example, if we are getting in a mathematical sum a particular answer wrong, then we may have to retrace all the steps because the mistake might lie in the first step. So, to get that answer right, we have to retrace all our steps. So, similarly, sometimes to understand one thing, we need to revise how we understand everything. So basically, whenever we act in life, we act based on a particular worldview. And sometimes that worldview itself might be wrong. And if it is wrong, then we can't make sense of that one thing without revising that worldview. This is what happened to Arjuna at the start of the Bhagavad-Gita. Arjuna was perplexed, mortified, afflicted by the question, should I fight or not? When it is my relatives who are against me, how can I fight against them? So now to answer this question, he initially was giving reasons why I should not fight. But then he recognized that to answer that question, he needs to understand what is dharma. And that's why we see when he asks the question also, it's a generalized question. In 2.7 he asks, Karpanya dosho pahata swabhava pruchhami tvam dharma sammoodha chetaha yashreyasya nishchitam bruhi tanme shishyaste ham shadhimam tvam prapannam. He says, I surrender to you, seeking to know what is dharma. What dharma means, what is the right thing to do? And to understand that answer, actually there is no simple straightforward answer that Krishna gives, fight or don't fight. Krishna actually changes, revises Arjuna's understanding of everything, beginning with his very self-identity. He tells him that as long as you think of yourself as your body, you will be caught up in should I fight or not fight. But when you understand that you are a non-physical self, that is like the foundational understanding which needs to be changed. That's like changing the first step in the mathematical sum. And then when we change our understanding of everything, okay, who am I? What am I meant to do? And how is whatever I am doing right now related with who I am and what I am meant to do? How does all this fit together? So that substantial revision of worldview and self-understanding is what the Bhagavad Gita gives. And that's how that same Arjuna who is afflicted and disheartened, casting aside his bow, unwilling to fight at the start of the Bhagavad Gita, Visrujya sasharam chapam shokasam vigna manasaha. That was his condition in 146. But that same Arjuna, by the end of the Bhagavad Gita, 1878, has become composed and calm and confident and is ready to fight. Yatra Yogeshwara Krishno Yatra Partho Dhanurdhara Tatra Shreer Vijayo Bhutir Dhruvani Tirmatir Mama. He is ready to fight by the side of the Lord and ready, equipped to march toward victory. So thus, rather than getting perplexed in trying to understand one thing that we view within our present worldview, if we strive to change our worldview, then what is in our current view will come in a clearer view and we will be able to move forward. Thank you. Hare Krishna.